Okay, good morning, good morning. Hello. Hello. Come on aboard. Come on and say hello while I get myself set up here. It's Monday and we are going to have a live sale. And it's going to be a fun one. Where is my marker that says where I am live? Is that me? No, that's not me. Let's see. How you doing? How you doing? Who's with me? Hi! I see Carol's watching. Hi, Carol, dear. How are you? Oh, I'm trying to wave to you, but I have my thing all weirded out up here. Feels like I'm dark, but the background's light. Oh. I have a lamp here. Give myself a little more light here. Start a fire here with all these lights here going on. Good morning, good morning. When you come on, come say hello to me. I see Mary's on. How are you, dear? Carol, I haven't seen you for a while. How was your 4th of July weekend? There's Nancy. Hi, Nancy. Let me find my stream here and get set up for sharing. Let's see. So how was everyone's 4th? Kind of low-key or what? What you got going on? Ours was very low-key. But we just went, we actually had a little picnic and a very small little isolated area. And that was nice because we could see 5 different sets of fireworks all around us. And we saw that incredible, incredible moon. Was that moon fantastic? There's Joan. Hi, Joan. How are you, dear? Did you all get a chance to check out that moon? It was low, it was huge, it was a full moon, it was fantastic. There's a name for it, I'm sure. There's a name for everything. But I thought that with the backdrop, with the fireworks and that moon, that looked just super, in my opinion. Absolutely super. Let me get this set up here. Where is my live stream? Oh, there I am right there, okay. See, so look at this huge sunflower. Oops, got to turn down my volume on myself here. Mute me. It's a mute me. It's a mute me. Hey, guess what? We're adding more prizes today. So, we had the French music on before. Now I decided this cafe music. I feel like I'm so dark. Can you see me? I'm gonna re-log in. You have no sound. Oh no. Gotta be able to hear what's going on there. Why do I feel so dark? I don't know if it's just because of the light coming in from behind me here. I have a separate lamp even sitting here too, which I'm not trusting with this bulb. It looks like the bulb's screwed in halfway or something. It's a weird one. Okay, well, it's gonna put that, how do I find its balancing method here? Sometimes I feel like I am walking around on a stack of cords, like there's snakes all over the floor. I got things balancing on this, things going on that. It's just kind of crazy there. Can you hear now? Fantastic. Okay, good. Good, 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 good. Okay, so let's get started here. So anyways, this is the, this is like a islandy cafe music today. I kind of like that. It is a little dark. I don't know how to change that. I got a light going right here. Got that light going, got this light going, got this light going. I'm just going to have to bring things a little bit closer for you. I don't really know. Let me try one more light here. Let me see if this one will work out here. Oh. Okay, almost there. I don't think that one's going to have much of an effect. Let's try this one, which is on a timer, of course, to override the timer. These aren't necessarily spotlights, though. But I could move this. I want you to tell me when it gets good, but I can't hear a word you're saying. Let's see, is that any better? Does that get any brighter? Let me see one more second. I don't know why it feels this way today. It's not like absurd weather or anything like that. Although it is going to storm a little bit later, I think. Oh my goodness. Let's put this one closer to the camera there. Now I really got cords going all over the place. I don't know. We're going to have to just deal with it. You can see me a little bit, huh? Okay. There you go. Ellen's there. Hi, Ellen. Hey, Kathy. How you guys doing? Good to see you. Good to see you. Okay. So let's get started here. So I want to tell you first of all, I really liked the other day when we did the little prizes in between on certain stickers. So we're going to do that again today because I thought that was just fun. It made it a little bit fun and lighthearted and everything there. And so I want to tell you that. And what else do I want to tell you? I know what I want to tell you. So you have to go and you have to share the show right now. Share the show so you can be entered into the drawing. And I will be drawing for shares of this show on Wednesday evening, okay? I'm missing the bottom part of this there, okay? Oh, and I see Judy's watching. Hi, Judy, how are you? So I'm gonna be sharing, or you share, you share, and then on Wednesday I'll be drawing for whomever, a random person that shared to win a prize then. But I have two prizes that I still have yet to give away, and one of them is to Mary. So Mary, when you were on there, you won the share prize from last week. So this is what you get a choice of, if you'd like. So the first item here, well, you get a choice of 50 assorted stickers for your car, water, laptop, whatever you like. 50 assorted stickers. They're about 3-inch stickers there. You could choose that, or you could choose this really cool little pair of sunglasses here. They have little diamonds around the sides there. Yes, they're diamonds. They are diamonds. I'm not just kidding. This is what they look like, Mary. Okay. So you can choose those. Or you could choose these, which are also kind of very cool. This is a set of 4 handmade cards from Kenya. Okay. And the thing that's really cool about them is not only is the paper handmade, okay, it's a paper pulp. Handmade paper, but then they have the paintings that are on there. And each one has been individually painted, and you can see that because you're going to get 2 of each style, but you can see when you look at the styles that they are a bit different from one another. Okay, you see how the trees are different. You know, they're working with the same pattern type of thing, but you can see the different artists' hands at work there. So you can either choose the 4 cards from Kenya here, which are really cool, handmade. You could choose the sunglasses, or Mary, you could choose the set of 50 random assorted stickers here. So whatever you like. Thank you, Ellen. Thank you for sharing. Yeah, make sure you share. I'll be able to see your shares at the end of the show, and then that person will be entered for a drawing on Wednesday night. Mary, you tell me which one you want. Stickers, cards, glasses, okay? We're going to get started here. So, as I said, I really liked the idea the other night when we were on doing the prizes from some of the numbers here. So I'm going to do that now. So this is my sheet of numbers right here. So I'm just going to randomly mark on here one in each of these columns here. So if you happen to buy one of the items that has a star next to it. Let me do one extra star here too. We'll do one right in the center. If you happen to buy one of the items that I put a star next to it, I'll let you know that it has a star next to it, but I'll let you know that, and then you're gonna get to pick from the prize basket as well, okay? So onward, upward, here we go. Okay, so first of all, there's this really cool backdrop. I got a new backdrop because somebody bought my last backdrop. Miss Joan bought my last backdrop. That last backdrop was so gorgeous, wasn't it? That castle. But this one's pretty cool too. This is just a huge, oversized flower blown up here. And I'm assuming it's a sunflower. I don't know if you can see down here towards the bottom here. You have a thick green stem here. This is hemmed on all 4 sides, okay? Similar to it, like a tablecloth. This is like a velvety sort of fabric though. It is machine washable and it has like a slight a fuzziness to it, okay? So it's like a velvety fabric. So there you go. It's kind of just this abstract art flower sunflower here. So if you like sunflowers, you could use it as a tablecloth. You could use it as a backdrop. You could use it as a picnic tablecloth, whatever you happen to like there. This item here is going to be item number 801, and this is going to be $6. Just $6 for that. And I want to tell you that it is probably, let me see here. I don't have a, you know, I cannot for the life of me figure out where I moved my yardstick to. But I'm going to say that this is probably 15, 30, 60, it's probably 60 inches that way and about 75, 80 inches across the top. Okay? So there you go. There's Amy. How are you? Hi, Amy. Okay, very good, very good. Okay, so now we're going to go to 802, number 802. This 802, I do have to say, and I apologize for this, but 802 is going to be a locals only can buy this, okay? Only because I know that I do not have the box capacity and wherewithal to make sure that I send this through safely to you. But number 802 is going to be this very large biscotti ceramic ginger jar here. Okay, it's number 802. It's going to be $6. Again, you have to be local to grab this one. Okay, you have to be a pickup person. It has a rubberized lid here at the top. Oh, and you can hear me echo in there, huh? But it does have some interior damage right there on the inside of the lid. Now, you can't see that when I put this lid on like that, but you do need to know that, okay? And that's why it's only $6, to be honest with you, okay? But it's gorgeous. Biscotti, ceramic, huge ginger jar. So if you like this one, you're going to say 802, but you have to be local. And that's why you're all giving me those mad faces. Is that right? Oh, I see Kate's on. Hi, Kate. How are you? Good to see you. Okay, is that why you're giving me all those mad faces? And where is Valerie? Somebody needs to go wake her up. What's going on with her? So anyways, if anybody local wants this one, it's going to be 802 and it's going to be $6. Okay? And we're going to set that aside. But do remind me, please. I know you'd say you'd want it, Joan, but I just don't trust mailing it. I don't trust mailing it because that really seems to be the type of thing that it would be nice to have a styrofoam cutout to fit it in perfectly, because I'm afraid it's just going to end up broken. Okay, so now we're going to go on here. We got 803. Actually, we got 803, 804, and 805 are all going to be the same item. Again, these items here, 803, 804, and 805, they're all new. And normally they would be higher priced than what they are, but I don't have the boxes for them, so you can't really give them as a gift the way they are. I mean, you could tie them onto something to give them as a gift. But these are these meat cloths, okay? These are the big, fat, bear meat cloths that you use to shred meat. Like if you make a roast pulled pork, something like that, barbecue, and then you want to shred it all up and you want to make sandwiches out of it. These are super duper heavy duty, strong and sturdy. They're not breakable at all. They're really strong, and they're only going to be $4 a pair because I don't have the boxes for them to go into. So we got item number 803 at $4, item 804 at $4, and item 805 at $4. Okay, three pairs of those. Great price. $4 is an excellent price on them. But they would be cool if you wanted to give them as a gift. What would be cool is if you took them away from the cardboard and you tied them onto a bottle of barbecue sauce, like just a pretty bottle of barbecue sauce or maybe a pair of tongs along with it and just tied a pretty ribbon on it. That would make a cool gift. So we got those three items there. Those are $4 each. If you like it, you just write the word sold, S-O-L-D, put a space, and then write that number that I assigned to go with it. Next item here, this is also a kitchen-y item here. Whoops, do I even see its price? Let's see. Okay, so these here, what does this say? These sell for $12 each, okay? They sell for $12, $12.82 or something like that, I think it says. I have them for $5. Okay, so these are called salad prep knives. I have two of them available here, okay? But I'm going to tell you this. You have to be a right-handed person for this to work for you here. Let me see what I've got going on here. Is my music too loud? If it is, just tell me. I'm going to turn it down just a teeny tiny bit so I don't feel like I have to compete with it here. Okay. Digging in the garden with what, the bear claws? Yeah, you probably could. You could probably rip up a lot of roots and stuff in there. Oh, your cousin from New York is on. That's wonderful. I don't see anybody saying hi to me from New York. Cousins, come and say hi to me. Okay, so what I noticed about these little knives here, these are called salad knives here, but I think you have to be a right-handed person to be able to use it, because if you held it with your left hand, the blade is down here, and although I'm not left-handed, I don't believe it's possible that that's how you're supposed to cut. So I think these are made for people with right hands. Do you have a right hand? Are you one of those lucky people that has a right hand? Okay, they sell for, I think it said $12.82. Okay, but I have them for $5 each. So what you are, they're hard. They're hard. They're not soft. They're hard. You hold it like this with your hand here, and then you have kind of a smooth blade here, a serrated blade here, and I don't know what the heck all these different size holes are that are going on the back right there. But it's a cool little thing. Plus, you can use it to clean up your mess when you're cutting your salads real quick. So it would be good for something like coleslaw or something like that. They're going to be $5 each. I got one at number 806. And I got another one at number 807. 806 and 807. Yes. Okay. Next item here. Okay, so this is another new item. This is a ceramic mug. This would make a great gift. It sells for $14.95. I have it for $5. It is a Scrabble ceramic mug. That little something right there. It is not permanent. N1, okay, ceramic mug Scrabble. It's going to be $5. It's number 808. 808, and it sells new for $14.95. I have it for $5. 808. Okay. And let's see. Number 809. 809 is going to be, woohoo, this without its lid. Where did its lid go? Okay, so this is really pretty. This is a stencil kit set. I shouldn't say it's a kit, but it's a large stencil. Foundations, wall, and floor template. Okay? And what the stencil is it's this lattice. It's this lattice stencil like this. I'll quickly give you a quick view here. It has some paper backing it here, so it might be a little bit tricky to see. But you unroll it, and it's a nice size. Put it down, start stenciling, start pouncing away with your little stenciling brushes and whatnot. You have can make a pretty little artwork there. I've actually used a lot of this lattice stenciling at a former location that I was at there. So it's a pretty nice design there, because then you can put flowers and whatnot through it. It's going to be $5. It's item number 809, and this one actually happens to have a star, so if somebody decides they want to get that, they're getting a bonus present with that one, too. Let me twist it back into its tube here. Number 809, he's on your watch party, but you cannot see comments or bid from there. I know how it is. Yeah, I know. Watch parties are kind of weird like that, but I appreciate you doing the watch party. I appreciate that, but yeah, you have to say to him, if anybody wants to make a bid, they have to be on the Art House Remix page to be able to bid from there. The bids cannot just come through from watch parties there. Okay. There we go. Okay, next item here is going to be item number 810, new item. This is a whisk broom, just a little whisk broom. Nice little whisk broom, straw broom. And it is called, brand called Quickie Bulldozer. It's going to be $4, number 810. 810 is $4. What is this thing here? Oh, this is really pretty. This is a little vintage item here. This is a ceramic plate, and it's hand painted. You see the snail on it here? Great coloring to it. This is from Italy, okay? And it says Fatto in Siena, Italy, a mano.
Chicacola? Am I saying that correct for snail there? This little plate here is going to be, and I'm going to say this is probably a 5-inch plate or so here. Coloring on it is fantastic. Really pretty. And then here's this maker's mark on the back here. And you see it also has a way to be able to hang the plate here from the holes here. And this plate, I'm going to put this plate down. We're going to mark this one down to $5 right now. If I can find my marker. Hey, Mark. I'm thinking of the movie called The Disaster Artist. Have you seen it? Hi, Mark. Hi, Mark. Anyway, $5 Italian plate. It's going to be number 811. 811. Okay, let's see. There you go. Oh, I also have to tell you, if I show you something that has a star and you decide that you want the item that has a star, alert me to it because I'm going to forget. Okay. And let's see, that was 809. So I'm going to forget. Once I move across me, it's gone. So you're going to have to say, hey, I won, or I bought 809, that sort of thing, okay? Next item here. Okay, these are, this is also a new item here. These sell for $14.99. I have them for $9. These are little footsie. Okay, you see them? But they're cool because on the outside, they're nice and soft like they're socks. But on the inside, they're super soft and jelly-like. So they're kind of cool. And they have individual little toes on them, too. So there's some little feet soothers here. Moisturizing gel booties. Five-toe moisturizing gel booties is what they are called. They sell for $14.99. I have them for $9. And it's going to be number 812. Number 812 is $9. Uh-oh, that was my basket of goodies. Next item here, this is a consigned item here. This is the movie called Finding Nemo. It's item number 813, and it is $4. Finding Nemo movie. It looks like it might be a double movie because, is it a double movie? Yep, there's two discs to it. Okay, there you go. Okay, $4, and this one is item number 813. 813. Let me put you over here. There we go. Okay. What is going to be 814? Well, let me tell you. 814 is going to be this very large glass-lidded jar. Okay, it has, it's like a, see the texture to it? It's a big jar. It's this big. It has a silver lid on it here that unscrews. Nice big fat jar. You could use that for cookies or whatever you like on your countertop there. Put a whole bunch of colorful gumballs in there. Anything you like. This one's going to be item number 814 and it is $5. This is a consigned item. $5, 814. Fantastic condition. 814. 814. And let's see what I've got here. Oh, this one's so pretty. This is a vintage item here. This is going to be 815. This is another ginger jar, but this ginger jar, it's a very old ginger jar. This one is from Japan, I believe. Let me see here. Yes, it's Japan. The brand is Norlings. It has a paper label on the bottom here. Oh, I can't read it because it's weird, but that's what it is. And look at this beautiful ginger jar here. It is ceramic. It appears to be in perfect condition here. I don't see any chips or cracks on it. It's beautiful. Look at that. From Japan, this is what the back of it looks like, just the one little part on it. This jar here, we had this jar at 16. I'm going to put this jar for $10 now. It's going to be item number 815, and it's going to be $10. And it's, I'm going to hold it up in a second here. I don't want to drop that part. Right, it's, I'm going to put it down to $10. It's gorgeous, though.
Look at that. Isn't that pretty?
So that item is going to be number 815.
And I don't trust it, so I'm going to wrap it here real quick. Don't want it to suddenly end up on the not feeling so well side. Okay. Next item here. So now I have a few of these. These are pretty interesting items here. These are all handmade here. Okay. And they're kind of interesting because they obviously took somebody a very long time to make them here. These are toy weapons here. Whoops. This one is number 816. It is made of wood. Okay. I don't know the different styles of axes, so I don't know if I could tell you that. But it is made of wood. It's thick, too. Look at how thick the wood is here. You see how my hand goes all the way around like that? And this is filed to be like a blade. Okay, I don't know if you can see that, the bevelness of it here. And it has, these are like little holes that are through here. Okay. Feathers, and it's all tied together. And it's super well made. I'm just really surprised by it here. It's really well made. Somebody that made this did a really good job. This one here is going to be number 816, and it's $8. This is how big it is here. $8. 816 is $8. And then we have this one here, which is 817. And again, this one, just crazy. This is an actual rock that is inside of this weapon here. This is an actual stone, a rock here. And this one here is also going to be $8. This one here is 817. This one has a star on it, too, on its tag. So if you get this one, let me know, because this one would be for a little added bonus here. This is what the top looks like. This is crazy. It has this awesome huge stone inside of it here. So again, I'm not familiar with the different styles of axes or what they're called, but that's that one. Got two more of these guys here. Well, this one isn't an axe. This one is a sword. This one looks more like a pirate sword or something. This one is going to be number 818, and it's $8. Can you see that one? How it's kind of curved up like that? Cool little gadgets here. Look at this. I'm just so impressed with the woodwork on it. I'm just so impressed with all of this carving, because this is all in from a block of wood here. This one's going to be $8. It's 818. And then I have one more. Oh no, I'm sorry. Two more of those. We have 819. Again, this one has stone on it. 819. Look at this massive stone. It would be like an address stone block there. And so this one has the feathers, and I guess this would be more like a tomahawk type chop thing. It's 819. It's $8. Even just all the drill work, even just all how it's all put together like that, really impressive. 819, $8. This would be great if you have a child in scouts. Those would be awesome things to take on to show off with other kids. And then the last one here is going to be 820 of this style item here. And this one is a smaller one here, okay? But it's still a decent size. And it replicates some sort of knife here. Now, of course, this is not going to cut anything. This is all wood that you see here. Pretty cool little item, though. This one's going to be $8 also, and this is item 820. 820. 820. So you never know what you're going to find on the shelf. You never know what you're going to find, and I never know what I'm going to find inside of a box, because it's just, you know, people have interesting items in their homes and whatnot. Okay, so this next item is going to be item number 821. This one here is going to be $5. It is a stainless steel It's like a handleless pitcher is what it is. Okay. And I see measurements on the inside of it here. So as you're pouring, you can measure in cups or in fluid ounces. I don't know exactly what this is, but it has this little blue fitted lid here that goes on top. Maybe you recognize it. Maybe it's a specialty item. I don't know. I don't recognize it. It's item number 821, and it is $5. 821 is $5. Then what do we have here? What is this? How do I get to everything? Feels like I got some heavy things here. This is a heavy one. This is a surprisingly heavy one. This is item number 822. 822. This one is going to be $5. It is a mirror, okay? It's a mirror, and this is the frame of the mirror here. It's all these tiny little seashells, but it is a brass mirrored here. And it's taped here with a painter's tape to keep it together. This, I want to say this probably weighs about 2 pounds. It's really a heavy duty piece of work here. So you'd have to hang it up there on your wall after you wipe off all my fingerprints that are on it there. This one's item number 822, $5. And again, like I said, that is a heavy piece. That's probably about 2 pounds right there. Item number 823. This one here is from Japan also. This one's going to be marked down now to just $4. Where's my marker? 823. This is a pretty little trinket box, porcelain trinket box. And it looks like it has lilies on it there. You can see it has some gold through the on the edges of the green and on the outside here. Pretty little trinket box, porcelain. There we go, marked Japan. I feel like my clarity is really off today on here. Very perfect, perfect in every way here. Perfect in every way. It's gonna be $4. It's number 823. 823, $4. Not a flaw on it. Number 824. This is a 50-piece set. It's going to be $5. These are envelopes. They sell for $8.49. I have them for $5. It's a 50-piece set, and this sort... Oh, these are the little snack envelopes, okay? So what you do is you open up these little envelopes like this. Say you were making treat bags or snail, what do they call that? Trail mix, and you fill it up with granola, whatever, that sort of thing. And then you can close it here with the Ziploc. And then I think this part here has a sticky, removable sticky here. So then you seal it. So they're sealed and protected, okay? And the next time somebody needs to open it, they actually have to rip it to get it open. So it's a safety sealed product here, okay? So if you make something like that, if you make something that you need to have sealed and protected and etc., it's going to be $5. You're getting 50 pieces in the package here. 50 pieces, and it's number 825. Oh, no, it's not. I lied. It's 824. I already stuck the sticker on it. 824. 824 for the 50 pieces. Next item here, this is just gorgeous too. This is going to be 825. This is a vintage ashtray, and it's from 1971, and this is going to be number 825. This item is going to be $16. This is a gorgeous vintage ashtray, and it's huge. Look how huge it is. You see that? That's got to be about 12 inches, and it's in perfect condition. It's ceramic. And you can see the center of it here is this pretty horse that they have here. I don't see a maker's mark or anything on it, but it's in perfect condition here. And so this would be like a centerpiece on your coffee table. This is a coffee table ashtray here, okay? But you don't have to use it for cigarettes or cigars or anything like that. I mean, you could use it just as an interesting piece on your table there, or you could use it as a little catch-all there for whatever you happen to have place, put your remotes or something like that.
It's number 825. It's $16, and it's from 1971.
Next, what do we have over here? This is a cute little thing here. This is a vintage souvenir that has never been used. It's from Germany, and it's going to be $5. Woo, there they go. It's a set of six photo coasters from Heidelberg. Looks like that. And then they look like that. So you're getting six different German images there from Heidelberg coasters. It's going to be $5 for the package of six. It's number 826. Number 826. Vintage coasters. I guess they are. Let me see what they are. What the backs of them look like here. Oh. The backs of them look. They look like a cork on the back of them there, but they don't feel like cork. They feel like they're protected, like the same way that the front is with the photo. It's like a photo image. Okay? That's what they look like here. And they're wood. The coasters themselves are wood. Germany. $5, Heidelberg, number 826. Okay, now these, I have two of these, and I love, love, love these, okay? I'm going to show you what they are here. Really love these. Okay, so these are the big, fat, braided rope, satchel bags, okay? So you can use these for laundry. You could use this as a laundry bag if you like. You could use the blanket storage. You could use it as a catch-all in the corner of your room. They're super heavy duty. This one here that I'm going to show you sells for $31.97. I have it for $20. I want to tell you what number it is, too. It's going to be number 827. 827. I'm going to show this to you here. It's so pretty. And this one here, you actually get two. You get a freebie one here because you get this small rope basket here. Isn't that pretty? It's like what do I want to call that? Maybe like tea with milk color here. So a little rope basket here that's about that size, okay? And then this is the other one that it comes with here, which is massive. Just massive. There you go. This is the extra, extra large rope basket here. Look at how huge that is. Fantastic. And this is, like I said, it's great. You could use it for laundry or something if you wanted to carry your laundry through the house. But these look fantastic, especially if like a boho style household there. Or I can even see this with this particular sort of coloring and everything in a traditional home as well, too, with, a traditional more wood-based home. The brand on this one here is called Fortouche. So you see the tri-coloredness of the fabric, and then this is the one that I showed you before. So this matches the bottom of this one here, okay? Really nice, really sturdy, heavy-duty rope bags here. So this one here, along with this freebie one, is number 827. And as I said, it sells for $31.97, and I have it for $20. So if you like that, you're going to write number 827. And then I have this one here, another one so pretty. I love it. I love it, love it, love it. This one here sells for $29.99, and I have this one for $20. Oh, and this one here is going to have a star on it, too, a star on its sticker. It's going to be number 828, if you like this. Now, this one here is a little bit different. You noticed how the last one that I had the rope handles going up like this. This one has the rope handles that are cut into the sides. Okay. Here we go. Look how pretty. I like this one. If you see that one up close with the rainbow-colored threading through it, and then this one has the braid detail as well. This one has the two pockets like this.
You could stuff toys in it if you wanted to. You could stuff doggy toys in it if you wanted to. I don't know. This one's pretty, because it's so light colored and everything like that. I don't know if I want my dog hanging around it too much. But, I mean, I don't have a shedding dog. But I know a lot of you do have shedding dogs. I don't know if you'd want your dog all hanging around it too much. But they're just really pretty. And they look so nice just sitting in the corner of the room there. Fill it with whatever you like. Again, this one here is going to be number 828. And it's going to be $20, and it sells for $29.99. Okay, now I need to catch up with you guys here because I'm missing some of your comments here. Okay, there you go. Okay, oh my gosh, I'm missing so many comments there. Okay, so there she is. So Valerie has entered the room. Yes, the Nemo DVD, I don't know. Was that what it was called, Nemo? I don't know if anybody bought it. Let's see what the number of it was. I don't know where it is. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Valerie, you can try typing it in to see if somebody bought it. The number is 813 on Finding Nemo. 813. So when you say the Nemo DVD, so one of my, and it probably might even be my most favorite movie of all time, is a movie called Mr. Nobody. And it's Jared Leto is the lead in the movie there. But his name in the movie is Nemo. Nemo Nobody there. So when you said the Nemo movie, I was like, oh, wait a minute. Okay, so are we back on track? Let me see. No, we're not, because I still have more to read. Okay, like a tomahawk. Like a tomahawk. Exactly. That's exactly what it was. Don't think so, Valerie. What? Oh, that Valerie. You know, I noticed, Kathy, you talked to the other Valerie the other day, and I think I was responding to you when the show finished and I looked at it, I'm thinking, oh, she wasn't even talking to me. She was talking to the other Valerie. Okay, there we go. Let's see. We good? More footage? More footage? What is that referring to? Oh my gosh, that would be awesome for the back of a vehicle to put groceries in and just carry the basket in. Oh my gosh, you would be so styling, Valerie, if that's what you took into the grocery store. Believe me, the Joneses are going to start salivating if you're carrying that beautiful piece into the grocery store. They're going to be like, oh yeah. Oh, there's Julie. I didn't even see you on here, Julie. How are you, dear? Julie says, I have rope baskets and you use them for your plants. There you go. Have planters in them. Love them. I could see that small one. Definitely. Oh, but you know what, Julie? Now that you're saying that, even if you had like a tree, I would line it with plastic first. I mean, I wouldn't want to have it seeping through there, but those would be great to be able to move such a heavy plant from one location to the other location. That's a fantastic idea. Let's see what else we got going on here. You love the basket, Babs. Yep. Show me Nemo video, please. I already did, dear. Winner, winner, Mary. Mary got a winner. Okay, Mary. So, Mary, this is going to be what your choice is for winner now. You get to pick one of these two items that are in the basket, Mary. Okay. So you either get to choose this set of the three ice cream. Whoops. No. We have two ice cream cones, but no, you get three of these little ice cream cone cuties here. These are just little squishy, little cutesy things that the kids like, those little softy, smooshy things, the three ice cream cones, or you get to choose this. Now, I've shown these for sale on here before, but this is the last one I have, and I don't have the instruction booklet and the bag that goes with it, so I don't know where the heck it is, but I've got stuff everywhere, so I don't know. But this is the security lock that you would use. You can use it in any door, okay, any door. But sometimes people would use these if they go to an Airbnb or a hotel. It's just an additional form of door lock that you put this inside of the door. So you can see actually the way it's cut. It fits right into the door there. It's kind of like the club, quote unquote, for your regular door. So Mary, do you want to say, you can say door or you can say ice cream. Let me know what you're going to say, door or ice cream. Okay. And then, there's more me. Look at you guys talking about with it. Okay, very good. Okay, so I'm all caught up here. Now let me take a drink. Okay. I don't know. We're missing Pam today, too. I'm sorry to hear that. Hey, so you know what? So in a little while here, we're going to end the show with $1. $1? Are they $1 items? Yeah, they're $1 items that we're going to end the show with when I come to that point in after a little bit. So that's going to be the super fast sale. I want to show you a couple pieces of jewelry we have on today's show here. Okay, so these are going to be the bracelets that I'm going to show you here. I'm going to number them here for you, and I know you're not going to be able to read these numbers backward, but I am going to work with you and help you out here. So we have five bracelets to show you, but the very first one, oh, wait a minute, hon. I'm putting the wrong numbers on here. I'm putting numbers from the second sheet on here, right? What numbers are we on? We should be on these numbers. I don't want these numbers on here. Hold on. Hold on. I screwed up. I wanted to save these numbers here for the dollar sale. I don't know how I messed that up. I think I already messed it up with something else. Oh, well. Pulling from both sides. Okay, so these bracelets, I'm going to renumber them here. We got number 829. We got number 830. We got number 831, which is going to have a star, 832. And the one that I'm wearing right now is 833. So these bracelets that I'm going to show you right now, these are all going to be $4 for each or for the ensemble of what they are. Mary wants the ice cream. You got the ice cream, Mary. Put your name on there. They're all falling out of the package now. Ice cream squishies. Mary, Mary, quite contrary. You're not contrary at all. You're agreeable. Okay, number 833 is this set. You're getting the set of three of them. These are little tiny sea turtle. These are stretchy bracelets here. You're getting a set of all three of them here. Okay, you got the orange, you got the green, you got the yellow, the little stretchy bracelets. That's going to be item number 833. Then we got this one, $4. And then we got this one, item 829. You're getting a set of two of these bracelets here. These are Italian looking bracelets here. I guess they could they also be Mexican, or can you, or do you have to have the white in between? I'm not sure. But these are like little rope bracelets here. And then you put it in like this, open them up. You're getting the set of two of these. They can be manly looking too, also. Two of those for $4. Those ones are going to be item number 829. 830 are going to be this set. You're getting the three bracelets here. These are stretchy bracelets, okay? And they have metallic colored beads on it. In golds, silvers, and copper colors here. They have little charms on it here that say things like wish, what does this say? Serenity, faith, joy, etc. That's sort of inspirational thing there. Peace. This one is $8.30 for the set of these three, which are going to be $4. $8.31 has a star on its sticker. $8.31 is a one bracelet that is a coiled bracelet like this. Okay. So you have some pretty little, these are more gray tones and it has some sparkles in it there too. So that's what this one would look like here. Looks like bangle bracelets, but it's all one piece here. Okay. That's going to be item number 831. And then lastly here for bracelets, we have 832. And this is 832. This is like a set of faux pearls here, a three-layer set here. And then the middle pieces, they're kind of like metal, but they have very thin slices. This might be kind of hard to see, but very thin slices of a capiz shell, the inside of a shell in there. So you can kind of see that there's some opalescent look to them there. So I'm going to show them once more on here. This is item 833, the three sea turtle bracelets. 829, the Italian bracelets. 830, the joy, faith, love, peace bracelets. 831, the coiled gray beads. And 832, the faux pearls with the capiz. And these are all going to be $4 each. So whatever one you like, Just write sold, S-O-L-D, leave a space, and then write that number that I assigned to that bracelet. And if you happen to like 831 and you're getting that one, let me know, okay? Ah, somebody got it. Who got it? Valerie got 831. Valerie got 831, so Valerie is also going to get a prize. A prize. Look at you, Valerie. You're going to get a prize. Uh-oh, getting my doggy all excited. Okay, so this is what your prizes are here. Valerie, you could either choose... Go lie down, please. You could either choose what Mary didn't choose, the key lock here, which she didn't choose, or you could choose two pouches of the Bay Tea, which is an energy tea. These are tea bags. You get 14 tea bags in each pouch. That's a set of 28. You're getting two pouches of those. Or we could also choose... These are two little doggy or pet. I shouldn't necessarily say it's for a doggy, but they're little kerchiefs. They're little kerchiefs, and then they have little snaps on them here. Now, I'm going to say these are for about the same size dog that Sparrow is. So, like a little medium size, maybe a 14-pound, let's say a dog that's maybe 8 to 16 pounds is what my guess is going to be for the little kerchiefs here. And like I said, they both have little snaps on the back. So say scarf, say tea, or say door, Valerie, whatever one you like. You said key lock. I know what you're talking about. I was going on, still talking. You were done. I was going on, rambling on here. Got to ramble on, sing my song. Okay, here we go. It's number 834. We had these the other day in pink. Now I have them here in silver. These ones are $6. These are the two-piece silver gray curtain tie backs here at number 834. These are the magnetic tie backs. These are the ones we were talking about that we like so much here. The other ones I had the other day were in pink. These ones are in, they say gray, but it's more like a silver. See how the magnets are here that forces them to tie back? So you just grab your drape, throw it around and tie it back like that, which I'm about to tie my hair back in a second because getting hot and warm. Very pretty here. So these ones are silver. They're number 834. If you like those, let me know. Write the word sold, S-O-L-D, 834. Right here's a new set of magnets. These are refrigerator magnets. These are 835. 835 also has a star on it. These are going to be $2. They're little vintage-inspired magnets here. Top one says, the office, only 40 years, 8 months, 94 minutes till retirement. And this one says, coffee, it's the plant. Is the planet shaking or is it me? They're little refrigerator magnets, number 835. They are $2. If you'd get this, you got it. There's, that was my Zeppelin impersonation. That was my Robert Plant impersonation. With my psychedelic flower going behind me here. My, it's almost like a firework, isn't it? 835. Let's see. Oh, and Valerie got this one. 835. Valerie, you just want the free prize. Isn't that what you want, dear? Okay, so Valerie, you're getting a prize on this one here, too. Let's see what you're getting here, Valerie. Valerie, you get to either choose the Bay Tea, Energy Tea, which Valerie didn't choose. The two doggy scarves here, or a bag of goldfish, which are 44 goldfish in here. Don't eat these, Valerie, if this is what you choose. These are rubber. You don't eat them, okay? 44 assorted goldfish from Rhode Island Novelty Store. I am entertaining. You have to see when I start singing my songs there. You have to see when I start breaking stuff live. Totally unprovoked, just my craziest. Plus, you get to also witness every hot flash I have. Aren't you lucky? Valerie, what are you choosing? Are you choosing goldfish? Are you choosing tea? Or are you choosing doggy kerchiefs? Let me know. Let me know what you're choosing. I'm going on to the next number here. Next number is going to be 836. 836. Let's see. 836 is a set of two. We got a set of two of these really pretty wall hanging pictures here. Number 836, they're going to be $8 for this set. They are framed in black. They are Asian inspired here. This one says, well, in American here, it says peace down here. And we're going to presume that this says peace. And this one here says harmony. And so these are, they look like watercolors, but I think they're prints, but they have a tendency to kind of look like a watercolor. They are behind glass, okay? They're black. They're about this big. So I'm going to say that's about 8x10 each. And they're just clean on the back like that. So you just have to apply your nail and hang them up on the wall. Very pretty prints. You get both of them for $8. It's number 836. 836, okay? Put that over here. What is she saying here? Kathy says, they would be good in ice cubes, Kathy. That's a clever idea, actually. You just don't want to choke on one of them. You'll put them with your dead babies. Okay, Amy. Also, I was going to say, I know I have a box that goes out to Amy today, too. But, and I had actually already sealed the box. And then I thought, oh, Amy wasn't on Friday. But I really think Amy wants to play my dead purple babies game. So you're getting dead purple babies in your box, Amy. Now, I know that you're thinking, what type of profane person would do this? I don't even know where they are right now at the moment, but they're itty bitty little tiny plastic babies, but they're purple, okay? So Kathy's teasing me that I'm suffocating, is strangling the babies, and they're turning purple in the bag here. But I thought, whoever wants to play, tell me you want to play the game, and I will send you each 10 purple babies, and then you have to plant them around town and photograph where you planted it near, kind of like in the vein of a Flat Stanley sort of thing. And then we can post all the pictures so we can see all the places that all the suffocated babies. This is terrible. This is terrible. Valerie, don't save any of that stuff for a video. Okay, next item here. But I think you want to play, Amy. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you want to play. So I'm sending you babies. Yes, I knew you would want to play. 837. This is a vintage cookbook. This is a cookbook from 1970. This one is $5. This is in excellent condition, this vintage cookbook here. It's a Campbell's cookbook, Cooking with Soup. It's a hardbound book that is also spiral bound here on the sides. As I said, it is from 1970, and this is gives you an idea of what people were eating in 1970. Okay, it's in excellent condition, this cookbook. It's number 837, and it is $5. $5 foot long. Okay, this one here, this is an expensive one here, but I'm marking it down even more because it's, I know it takes the right person, but this would make a great gift. I'm taking it down to 10 bucks now. But these are like 30 some bucks. This is called a Houdini Magic Chinese Linking Rings. Okay. So what it is, it comes in the box. They are 8-inch rings. 8-inch Chinese linking rings. And it's just these heavy duty rings here that teach you how to do all of the basics. They teach you how to do all this different magic stuff. So if you have a budding magician in your home, which usually hits, I think that, in my opinion, it often hits boys between like 8, 12, and then if they get interested in it, then they'll kind of continue on with it to be 15, 16 towards adult. Maybe you already have an adult. Anyways, it's a great item. It's a great gift. It would make a great gift. It's called Magic Rings. All you have to write is sold, $8.38. If it's something that you want, it's going to be $10. $10 for the 8-inch rings. Woo! All these lights around me now. Well, at least I'm glad you guys can see me. It doesn't sound like you're complaining that you can't see me. Your nephew would love this, the rings. So, I can't open your box. I already have a label on your box. Sorry, I already bought your label, dear. But I will have to get you a new box started, and we can wait. This is how I handle it normally here. So if you are somebody that likes to watch the shows and you're always on buying things here and there type of thing, I'll just keep your box open. And then when your box is filled, then I send it to you. And that way I can be sure to see that you're getting a really good postage rate too, because obviously
a food box, you know, is better than sending one item, you know, how many states away or any of that type of thing. So, but your box actually is already ready to go, Amy. Yours already has a label on it. But I don't have to mail your anything you purchased today until you have a new full box, which is fine. Okay, next item here. This is a Sewing Notion item. This is going to be $8. There's a ton of this on here. How much is on here? 12 yards. 12 yards. Oh, my goodness. Of this pretty... It's kind of like a sage color, green, beaded, just tons of it. What do they call this stuff? Trim. Trim! They call it trim! Green beaded trim. You get 12 yards of it on here. New package here. From a company called Onso, O-N-S-O, Onso Company, palette. It's called Palette Trim, P-A-I-L, Palette Trim. Okay, 8 yards, going to be number 839. So that is less than a buck a yard. Can make some pretty projects with that. Number 839 for the trim. Okay, what's next over here? Okay, so this next item here. So this is an over-the-door mount. This is metal, okay? Play the triangle. Okay, so you could play the triangle. These hook onto your door. They're over the door mount like this. So they will stick out from your door like that. And then in here sticks one of these rods, which of course once I put it in, then I have to pop it out and everything. But you get how that works here. I'm just gonna put the one side in here. And so it sticks in over here like this. You can hang clothing from hangers over here on the front, or you can hang things on the sides like that as well, okay? So that's what it is. It's an over-the-door mount. It's gonna be $5. It's gonna be item number 840. 840 is gonna be $5. Over-the-door mount. 840. There you go. Okay, let me put that over here. Over-the-door clothing mount, 840. Oh my gosh, this box is almost empty now. 841. Last item in this box, 841, is this pretty little ceramic plate here with a fat cat on it. It's going to be $4. The brand is called Roster. And it's a textured plate here too. So you see it's like a, it's just a little display plate here. Okay, if you like fat cats, there's a fat cat for you. Oh, looks like it was eating a lollipop, but it's actually flowers. Fat cats with a lollipop there. It's going to be $4. It's number 841, ceramic plate. 841. Let me move this out of the way. 842 is too cute. 842 is this big, fat... It's big, fat unicorn. Isn't he cute? The big fat unicorn, he's soft, he's plushy, squishable. He has a cute little gold horn at the top. Oh, you're not a big fat unicorn. Look, come to join me. Come here, say hi. He says, now that I moved that box, there's room for him up here. But I gotta put a new box up. Unicorn. Yeah. This one's gonna be $4. And this one is item number 842. 842, unicorn. Okay. I'm going to stick a sticker on this one here. He's going to be $1.99. He's so cute. $1.99. He's going to get a big fat bone. He's going to get a big fat bone. Oh, pumpkin bone. Where'd it go? Oh, he didn't hear that one. He didn't hear that one. Oh, no, Mama ruined it. Here we go. Go get it. Okay, there you go. And let's see which one this one is. Another one. Too cute. Too cute. It's Rex from Toy Story. Squishy little Rex from Toy Story plushie here with his tiny little arms. They can't do anything. My arms are too tiny. That's actually my Ben Stiller impersonation. I cannot do anything.
I need to go for kids' school for people that want to be smarter. 843 with a star. If you get him, he has a star. He's number 843. He's also $4, 843. So cute. It is so soft. I know. I just love getting some of these things in, and they're like, oh my gosh, they're just so squishable. Reminds me why you like, why we like this kind of stuff. This is a salad spinner. This is $4 here. Oops, how does it work? Why isn't it spinning my salad? Do I have to attach something here? I think I have to attach this bowl. How does that work? Oh, I have to fit it into the top like that, probably, huh? And then put it like this. This is all plastic. Nope. How does it work? Ah, people, I don't know how to spin my salad. I need to see about this one. Hold on. Why isn't this part spinning? Okay, we're not going to do this one. I can't figure out what's wrong with that one. It doesn't seem to want to work. Sometimes those things happen. It's live. You never know what's going to happen. Next item here, this is a new item. So do you guys ever play this? This ladder ball? It's a great summertime picnic-y party game. These are the replacement sets if you need more balls for it. But basically, it's just a ladder with three long wooden dowels on it that you can simply build out of anything. And these balls, they come two balls on here, and they're attached by the rope. So you toss the ball and you try to get it either on level one, level two, level three, with getting more points as you, you know, deal with the harder ones there. You kind of play in teams or you can play one-on-one. Ladder ball set here. This sells for $14.95. This is a replacement set. You're getting it for $8. $8, and this is number 844. 844. Safe weighted bolas. Play like real golf balls. Interesting. But you squeeze them, they're soft, it says. Yeah. Okay. But still, I wouldn't want to get whacked in the head with one of them. Anyway, it's number 844. 844. And that was $8. And now this one here, these are pretty cool here too. How do we open this? Okay, so they're both identical, so I'm just opening one for you to see here. Okay, so this is kind of like, you know how you have like a Lazy Susan for your kitchen that would spin, you know, like on a track that spins things like that? Well, this is kind of like a square. I don't know why I'm saying Lazy Susan, but that's kind of what it reminds me of. This is a rectangular piece here, okay? And they call this a sliding kitchen caddy. So what it's made for, it's made for you to put on your appliances. So here you see a coffee maker is on it, but you can put a toaster on it, you can put any of your appliances on it, and you put this on your countertop like this. It's black. That's what it looks like. And it just slides out. So you have your this against the wall. Everything's tucked nice and neat against the wall, your coffee maker, your whatever you have. You can even put your knife set on there, or your, you know, whatever you have, your paper towels, napkins, whatever you like. And then when you go to use it, they just slide right out on these rolling trays here. So you're getting, and these trays are about this big, which are, do they have a size measurement on here? Let me see. I don't see it. I don't see a size measurement on here, but you're getting actually two of these, okay? So you're getting two of these. The price of these are going to be $10 for the two of them. Let me see. I don't see a size measurement on here, but I'm guessing this is probably about 15 inches by about 10 inches. Okay, that's my guess. You're getting a package that has two different ones in here that, of course, both black so that they match each other here. They're going to be $10 for the two-piece set. This is the size of the box here. It's going to be number 845. 845. 10 bucks for the two pieces. 845. Okay. Next is this. This is, I don't know if this is technically vintage yet or not. Okay. Who do we got going on? We got Joan. We got Joan as a winner, 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 winner. Is that what I see? Joan. We're going to stop right for a second. We're going to make Joan get a prize here. Joan, what prize are we going to give you? Let's see. We gotta get the Valerie's fish out of here. She's gonna make
She's going to make fish cubes. She's going to make weird fish cubes at her house over there. Okay. Come on, let's go here. Okay, let's go. Okay, so Joan, you get to choose one of these three items that are in this basket. Oh, you didn't choose fish, did you? Did you choose fish?
Well, I'll have to.
Did you choose the fish? I thought you chose the fish. But then I kind of thought you chose the key, but maybe you won twice. You've already. Joan, you could either choose this item here, which is the long linen gray scarf. Okay, this is the one that I said is super huge. This is probably about 10 feet long, this linen gray scarf. It has serged edges on it. I thought it was a dresser scarf. Maybe it's a bed scarf. I'm not sure exactly what it is. Super long, super huge. You get to either choose that if you wish, or you could choose this white musk car freshener deodorizer here. These sell for $7.49. You could choose that one if you like that. Or you could choose the two packages of the Bay Tea Energy Tea. Okay? 14 bags per thing. You did pick fish. I thought so. I'm just writing your name on it now so that I know for sure. I don't forget. Okay? Oh, see, this is where I got screwed up. I put a sticker on it or something. I don't know what I did. Here we go. You're getting that one, Valerie. Let me mark off that sticker so I don't confuse myself. More than I already am. Oh, did Pam get on? Hi, Pam. How are you? Okay, Joan, you tell me which one you want to win there, and I'm going to put that one aside for you. Next item here, as I said, I'm not sure if this is exactly vintage, but it is older, okay, because I've looked these up online. They're already, you know, they're collectible there. How you doing, Pam? Joan, you want the scarf? Good thing. I'm setting it aside with your name on it, Joan. J-O-A-N. Joan gets the scarf. Thank you. Thank you for playing. Thank you for winning. Okay, so this is really pretty, and I've seen that these have become collectibles, so I guess these are, if they're not already, I don't know if their vintage is considered 20 years or more, so I don't know if this is 20 years old or not, but these are a collectible item here. This is a brand called April Cornell, C-O-R-N-E-L-L. These are pretty little teapots, and apparently they make all of these different little teapots here. I'm going to say this is a two-cup, three-cup teapot here, tops, probably two cups teapot here. Very pretty little ceramic teapot here. And it is in perfect condition. See? Looks fantastic. Pretty little lid on it there, too. It's going to be $7. This is going to be item number 846. Pretty little teapot. 846. Great condition. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And again, the brand on this is April Cornell. 846. $7 for this pretty little girl. Pretty little girl. Pretty little girl with a red dress on. Wonder if Amy can figure out what song I was referring to with that. Can you figure out, Amy? Pretty little girl with a red dress on. Okay, next one here. These are hysterical. And, excuse me. Let me cough for a minute. Let me take a drink for a minute. These are hysterical. I know, I always feel, I think a lot of things are hysterical, but these are hysterical. Okay, so this also relates to, kind of, there's a movie on Netflix. Now again, not everybody's cup of tea, but a lot of the movies I watch are not everybody's cup of tea. But if you get the chance to see it, it's called, ready? The Lobster. Look at my lobster hands. So these are new. They are fabulous. They are rubber lobster hands. They're like, so they're not a pot holder, okay? I would not put heat onto this. I don't think that that would be safe for the oven, at least. For the microwave, it would probably be fine, but I don't think I would use it for the oven. Plus, it's kind of silly. But if you were having, like, a low country boil or lobster feast of some sort, you know, whatever, I think these would be great to carry out and demonstrate, you know, and, hey, everybody, where's our lobster feast? So these are going to be $6. These are more like a, they're heavier duty than a disposable
latex kitsch dishwashing glove, but they're just like a heavier rubbery glove, okay? So you got these two big fat lobster claws. I think they're just hysterical, though. They're going to be $6. I'm going to wash that lobster. There you go, lobster. I got the lobster. It's going to be $6. It's going to be item number 847. So the lobster is a rather interesting movie because in the movie, they have to find a mate. You know, the single people, they have to find a mate. And so they don't have a whole lot of choices. Everybody's in this real state of apathy all the time, you know. And so they try to make it work, and if it doesn't work, then they have to dispose of that mate. They have to try to find another mate and all of this type of thing. But if they don't, then they have to be taken off the earth because there's no purpose for them unless they're going to mate and recreate, you know, procreate. And the kindness that is bestowed upon them is that if they are taken off of the earth, at least they get to choose what it is that they want to be reincarnated as, to come back as. So I won't spoil the movie for you. The movie title is called The Lobster. It's number 847 for these gloves. They're going to be $6. Geez, do I look yellow? I don't know if it's because I have this big yellow behind me and I'm wearing yellow or what the deal is, but there looks like a lot of yellow going on. I gotta show you some jewelry here. I gotta show you some special jewelry here and something even special. Okay, is it raining? Oh, it is raining. My dog has just stopped right here looking out, and it is raining. Okay, so this next item, again, really takes a special buyer. Don't know if it's going to be somebody that's actually watching the show or not. Gorgeous, though. What a find. Look at this. It is a vintage jewelry box. Mid-century jewelry box here. It is the brand, I'm going to say it, I say Melee. I don't know if it's Melee. It's M-E-L-E. Maybe it's Mel. You know, I don't know what it is. It's made in the USA, M-E-L-E. Vintage jewelry box. It has the gold filigree scroll pattern all around it here. The box itself is ivory colored. So the box that works like this, and it's large. You can see how large the jewelry box is. My mother had one very similar to this. Hers was, I had two drawers here though instead. But this one, when you open this, here I'll open this this way. When you open this, it automatically opens the bottom of your jewelry box. See how that works? Hinges, perfect condition all the way around. The interior of it is lined in a felt velvety fabric here. And again, with the gold on it here, we have the mirror on the inside. The top part, it's kind of hard to see here. The top part, you have slotted for your earrings and whatnot. Then you have some slotted dishes down here for your larger pieces. And then of course your drawer has three spaces on the bottom for your jewelry down here. Gorgeous and great condition. Here, the bottom of it is green felt. Really nice. Really nice. So if you're into this vintage jewelry box type thing, this is a really nice one. And this one, you're going to, and if you are interested in it, you're going to be impressed with my price on it too. Because, ugh, I'm losing my glasses. Because I priced this one here at only $28. And if you're going to go right now and Google these, you're going to find them a heck of a lot more than $28. Fantastic. I was really impressed with it. Okay, so this one here is going to be $28. And mid-century jewelry box here. This one is going to be item number 848. 848. Let me get its little sticky stick off. There we go. Stick this on the bottom at number 848. Now, I want to show you what's inside the jewelry box. What's inside the jewelry box, Seneca? Did you have one like this? I remember my mother had one like this, too. I think hers had two drawers on the bottom, and I think hers had, for some reason, I remember it having gold knobs, too, to be able to pull open. But this one was not made that way. And it's funny, because when I did research these online, they came in so many different, that all had the similar type of look, but just such a wide selection of styles, which was actually really impressive because, you know, it's not cost efficient for a company to create, 38 styles of jewelry boxes in a particular line, you know. So I thought that was really interesting, you know, that they had so many different styles from the same brand here. But really pretty. Yeah, I love it too. I love it. Okay. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. What did you say? What was it? Pretty little girl with the red dress on. Poor Otis, dead and gone. Yep, it was the Doors. You're right, Amy. Amy! So it's funny because my neighbors that live across the street, which they might be watching, I don't know. I look so jaundiced with all this yellow going on around me and the purple hair. They're young. They're like, if they're 30, I don't know. And when I got my Facebook Live ban and I had to do my things outside, and the one day I'm sitting out there and I'm hearing coming out of their house is all the Doors music. And I was like, whoa, that's kind of a, I don't know. I didn't even know that they would be that familiar with them. I shouldn't say that. I mean, my son is 26 and he's familiar with it, but I don't see him spending a day rocking out to the Doors. But I don't know. Okay, let me show you the jewelry I got inside of it. First of all, none of this jewelry that I'm going to show you right now is vintage, okay? This is all modern costume jewelry that I'm going to show you right now. Need a little sip. Need a little wetting the whistle here. First one is this one that I have on right now. Can I get any closer? Okay, maybe I can't. This one, I decided to put this on because it was purple, and it might going to be able to take it off alone. This is usually a job that I save for somebody else to do. Okay, I'm not going to do that one right this second here. But well, there's six others in here. Let's see. So this very similar to this one, purple one here. We'll start with this one here. Is this gray one. So it has this pretty little gray stone. Guys, see the marker on my hand? Sorry. Up on the front. And then it has some little rhinestones in the antique colored metals that go behind it. It has the twisted cords here. They look to be gold beading, seed beads, gold seed beads in shades of gray. Okay. Little chain closure at the top like this. It's about that big. It's very similar to this one that I have on, except I have the purple one on. Okay. That's what it looks like. It's going to be $4. This is going to be item number 849. 849 is going to be $4. 849. Let me see if I can get my purple one off yet. I might not be able to because I can't. Oh, there. Wait. I found it. Okay. There we go. Okay. The next one is the purple one. Very similar to the one I just showed you there. This one has the purple stone. Rhinestones on the top, almost like a peacock selection of seed bead colors there, along with the gold seed beads and the purple cording throughout it. That's the one I was just wearing here. This one is also going to be $4. This one is going to be item number 850. 850. It's also going to be $4. We finished a sheet of stickers. Let me get some, where's my maca? Here's my marker. Hi, Mark. Did anybody see that movie? Did anybody see that movie called The Disaster Artist? It's a true story. It's on Netflix. It's about this guy that is just kind of a schlummy, bummy guy. And, you know, he wants to make this movie. He wants to make this big budget movie. And people don't take him seriously or anything like that. And it turns out he's extremely wealthy and he starts financing this really huge, big budget movie, but it's terrible. The movie is just terrible, terrible. Anyways, it's become a cult classic now because the acting is so terrible in it. I mean, everything. So not only do you get to watch The Disaster Artist, but after you're finished watching The Disaster Artist, then you kind of want to see the actual movie. Well, Netflix has the actual movies on there, too. We're starting a new sheet. I'm putting some new sticky stars on here. Although, I don't have too many to do on here, so I'm going to put them closer to the top. We'll put one here. We'll put one here. We'll put one here. Because, oh, I guess I got a couple to do in here. What do y'all say in here? Okay, next thing. So we've got the purple one. Here's the next one. This one, also $4. I just said peacock colors on the last one, but this one is definitely has some peacock colors going to it. There we go. It's a green stone in the center. It has kind of some blue rhinestone here with some antiqued metal finishings on the outside. It's going to be $4. Again, with the peacock kind of colors going through with the seed beads, the gold beads, and then the turquoise. $4 for that one. That one's $8.51. If you get that one, it has a star on it. Let me know, and I will, you know what I'll do? I'll give you a prize because it has a star on it. And then there's this one here, which is similar, very similar, but does not have the rhinestones. So this one is going to be number $8.52. This one, this, if that looks green to you, it shouldn't. It's actually blackish gray. So if my camera is picking that up, because the way it looks to me right on my camera right now looks green, but it's actually more blackish gray. And then this one, it does have rhinestones. Oh, I'm sorry, couldn't even notice that there, because they're more like a they're more like an onyxy color rhinestone there at the top. They have the black seed beads, the gold seed beads, and then they have the gray, dark gray cording that goes through it here. Very similar to the other ones. This one is $4. It's number 852. Really raining out there. It's really raining out there right now. That one is 852. Take them that way, please. Huh? That's okay. That's okay. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay. 852. So then we have this one here, which is also going to be $4. Now this one here is, let's see what we got here. We got some black beads. We got some silver beads. We have some, here, let's see. And we have some clear and some metal beadwork here. This is a one piece long like this. There you go. You can always double it if you like, or you can just wear it long like that. It hits you right about here, about four inches above the navel or so. Very pretty. If you were to double it, something like that. You can adjust it however you like. It has the, okay. Very pretty. This one here is going to be number 853. It's going to be $4. We got winner, winner, Joan. We got winner, winner, Joan. Okay, winner, winner, Joan. Hold on, Joan. I'm getting stuck to all the stickers here. All the stickers are sticking to me. Okay, Joan, where's my winner basket? Oh, here it is. Okay. Joan, where are we going to put you in our winner basket here? We are either going to get you... Let's see. Let's see what I can get you over here that I haven't shown you before here. Okay, so Joan, oh, I hear the rain is changing directions there. Joan, tea, try the tea. Try the musk, car freshener. Try the two storage bags, or try the emergency car blanket here. Keep it in your glove box here. It's one of those Mylar blankets that... They say these work really well, and they're good for campers, too. So if you have somebody in your holiday list that's a camper person, that might be a good thing there. They say they work very, very well. So you tell me which one you want, dear, okay? And I will set it aside for you. Here's another pretty necklace here. Again, not vintage. This is just a modern necklace. It has a green crystal in it, and it has a little kind of almost like a chain tassel at the bottom here. Larger metal loops here down to your necklace. Looks like that. That will go good with what I have on here right now, actually. Wouldn't it? There you go. Pretty? hangs right here, hits you right in the Heimlich maneuver.
right in the soft spot there. Okay, this one here is going to be number 854. Put that one over here. Okay. Number 855. We have this pretty little piece. This again has the tassel chain at the bottom. And then we have all these sparkly little, these are almost ice cream colored, candy colored gems that are going up the front here. They look like they're in oranges and light pinks and dark pink. I'm going to show you a close up of that if I can here. Little faceted gems here. Cute, pretty.
It's going to hang probably about right here is where it's going to start. Okay, once it wraps around the back of your neck. So you have the little tassel gems that hang down here. This one's also going to be $4. This one's going to be number 855. 855. And then this one here is a set. This one here is a set of, it's like a tortoise stone, clear or acrylic. And these large beads that are put together, these large circles which are put together with the metal work circles here in the center. Okay. So it's like this. I know I'm wearing too busy of an outfit for you to really get a great idea of it here. This is the lowest where it hangs down to, right here. Not only does this one, that's how it goes, have the necklace, but this one also has a set of matching pierced dangle earrings that accompany it. Okay, that set's gonna be $5. It's gonna be set number 856. Got a couple more pieces here, and we'll be finished up with the jewelry here in just a second. I have about four more pieces I want to show you. Here's a little pair of dangle earrings. These earrings are going to be $3 a pair. These are just little blue facet stone cut here. No, excuse me, these are not stones. These are just little plastic beads, actually. Blue, pretty, dangly. There you go, those ones are $8.57. These ones are $3. Then we have this one is $8.58. $8.58 are black beads that have been wired here. These are black, that color is black. Okay, this is $8.58. Hang over the back like that, 858. 858 actually has a star on it too, on the label if you decide you want those. These ones are $3. Then we have this one here, which is 859. These ones are kind of cool. I like these ones because these look kind of, I don't know, they just look kind of Asian, I guess Eastern somehow here. These are also kind of like a simulated tortoise stone here, or acrylic. But I like the way they're all cut out like that. I want to say these are about the size of a 50 cent piece here. These are $8.59. And I have three more pieces here of which to show you. We have these ones here, also $3. The earrings are $3. This one here, wow, it's really raining out there. This one here, this is a blue colored bead in the center. It's a blue colored plastic bead that looks kind of rockish looking. It's a little bit like a stone. It's number 860. Ooh, dangle, dangle. 860. They hang down to about here. They're $3, 860. And then these little clear ones, 861. Nancy got a winner? Okay, very good, Nancy. Give me 1 second. You enjoy the music, Joan?
Okay, good. You got the storage bags. You got the storage bags, Joan. They're for you. I'm going to put your name on those. I need to, you know what I really need to do is get a marker that has a string attached to it. So that I know where my things are. Magnets or something. There you go. These ones here are the clear. They are a clear acrylic earring here, dangle earring. These ones are number 861. 861. On the gold metal, gold colored metal here, 861, $3. And lastly for our earrings are these ones here. These ones are black, number 862. These have silver colored backings here. These look like little stones. 862, little black onyx stones is what they look like. Little stackable stones. 862. And they also, I just taped it down, but they do have the dangle, the fish hook style back. 862. Okay. That's exactly what these remind me of, like tiny little stacked stones. Actually, you know what they remind me of? They remind me of those magnets that you play with in your hand that are just, that you buy at the rock and gem stores, like by the pound or whatever, you know, and you can stick them all together and arrange them. That's what they kind of remind me of there. So those ones are $3 each. I'm going to close my magic jewelry box here. Love this jewelry box. What a bunch of memories come flooding back when you get something like this in too, you know? Okay, and we got a couple more items, and then we are going to start our $1 sale. How are we doing with that? We're doing good. Okay, next item here. This is... I should have just had this out the entire time. This is a pretty handmade straw fan here. Kind of looks like the shape of a butterfly here. You see, it's all straw through the whole thing here. This one's going to be $5. Let's see if it works. Oh, yes. Now I need the grapes, and I'll be good to go. $5. It's going to be item number 863. 863, $5. Really pretty. It's a nice... You know what? I love hand fans, and I love using hand fans, and I love pulling out my hand fans when I'm sitting in the middle of a music festival or whatever, and people are jealous that I have a hand fan, and they don't have a hand fan, and I don't know. I really like hand fans, but this is a pretty one, 863, really pretty one. Not collapsible, but yet pretty nonetheless. This one here is a new item. It is a ball cap. It is a Cabela's ball cap here. From the sports and outdoor store Cabela's here. It's a new item here. It has an adjustable back here, and it just has it says world's foremost outfitter is what it says in its gold embroidery and the embroidered patch on the front, and it's kind of green colored here. There you go. Cute. It's cute. If you have an outdoorsy person or a hunting type person or somebody like that, somebody that likes to have Cabela's in their life, you're going to find this a bargain. This is a $8. $8. Oh, and this one also has a magic star that goes with it too. $8. It's going to be item number 864. If you get this item, let me know and I'm giving you a prize to go with it. 864. You okay? It's rainy. What am I supposed to tell you? It's very, very rainy out there. Okay, next, I have two more items to show you, and then we are doing $1, okay? So stay with me, people. Two more full-price items, then we got $1 items. This, gorgeous. Okay, item number 16, or excuse me, it sells for $16.90. I have it for $12. It is this very pretty mandala looking fabric, tapestry fabric looking thing here with the white pom-poms on the bottom, and it is a floor cushion pillow case here. So it has a zippered back on it here. You can unzip the back and you can put inside of it, you can put, you know, foam inside of it if you want to. You can just put polyfiber fill inside of it. You can rip up a couple of old pillows and stick them inside until it's nice and plump the way you want it. I actually, it's funny because when I was got this in last night, it reminded me of something else. And I texted my aunt,
my auntie.
We had this conversation the other day, auntie, aunt. And I texted her because we had, in our family, we had some beautiful leather ottomans from Nigeria. This is many, many years ago. This is 50 years ago, probably. And they were leather, and they were quilted, but they had a nice busy pattern on the top of them. But what we stuffed them with, you know, because they came over, folded leather, you know, it wasn't, they weren't stuffed when they came over, because my uncle lived there. But my second uncle. Now I get into my side stories here. None of that is relevant here. Nonetheless, when he brought them over flat, and then we stuffed them. And what we stuffed them with back in the day, and you may have something, a story like this that's similar back in the day, but we had our ottomans stuffed with newspaper, and just stacks and stacks of newspaper on it. They were heavy as all heck to move around. We had to get on the floor and roll them to move them. But they were big, fat ottomans, leather ottomans that were stuffed with our newspaper, and then they were laced up on the bottom. Anyways, doesn't have a whole lot to do with this, except for that this is a really pretty floor pillow tapestry with a zipper in the back and little pom-poms off the side, you know, inspired Indian the boho look and everything like that to it. This one here is $12. It sells for $16.90. I have it for $12. And this one is going to be item 865. Anyway, when I texted her about those last night, I said, where are those? And does somebody in the family still have those or not? But she wasn't familiar with it. I mean, she's like, oh, I don't know. She said, I could ask around, but you know. It's been a long time. You can't get your hopes up out of something. It's been a long time. Okay, so anyways, that's just a big old rabbit trail I went down. A big old, fell in the hole there. It's $8.65, 12 bucks. $8.65 is 12 bucks. And then I think I saw, we had Nancy as a winner here. Nancy, fancy Nancy. Where the heck did my basket go? Oh, I'm putting things in my basket. That's why I can't find my basket. Okay. Nancy, what did I get? Did I get Joan what she wanted to get? I hope I did. Okay, Nancy. So yours, we're going to add here. We're going to add one more into yours, Nancy. Okay, Nancy, try the tea. Why is everybody objecting to trying the tea? I'm going to put a tea in everybody's order to make sure you try the tea. Energy tea. Two packages of energy tea. You get the white musk, what do you call it, car deodorizer, or the blanket here. For your car, or you get a set of, I don't know how many are in here, maybe 10 or 12. You get the blue shiny latex balloons, but you also get the clear latex balloons. These are 12-inch balloons with the blue confetti inside of them there too. So you get a package of those, however many are in here. Choose what you want. Let me know what it is. We have two more things to show you, and then I am on to my dollar. Okay. I don't know which to show you first. I love them both. I'll show you the one that I can't mail. Can't mail this one. You got to come and you have to pick it up if you want this one here. I like it. I think it's very cool. It's going to sell for $12. It's metal. It's a hamper. It's big. It's hinge lid. It's like a filigree. Look at that. You can see right through it. I can see you. You might not be able to see me, but I can see you. See? Isn't that cool? It's a metal hamper. Sits on the four little legs down here. Does look like it does have a slight dent right here, but you have to really be on the lookout for it to be able to see it because of the pattern to it here. Has this cool little scrolly hinged lid that opens up like this. And it's nice and it's big, and it's about this big actually here. So it can fit a lot of your clothes into it. You have to be a local buyer for this one. This one can't mail. It's going to be $12 for this one here. And this one, woohoo! This one here is going to be number 866. 866, $12. Really a nice piece. I like it a lot. I like it because it's artsy looking too. Set that up here, please, so it doesn't get damaged. Thank you. And then last, I saved this one for last because I super love this one here too. Watch this one. Okay.
You know when I come through and I'm like, watch this. Watch this. No, I love this guy here. He's going to be number 867. There he is. He's a hinged crow, and he is made all of wood, and he can sit on your whatever, on your refrigerator, on your shelf, on your, you know, outside on your porch, whatever you want. He has these hinged little feet here. So cute. Black bottom on his bum here, so he can sit on what he needs to sit on. His wings are done on both sides, the insides and the outsides of the wings. And he's just a cool little crow. Actually, he looks like a plague mask right there, right? Is this a crow? Is that right? Is it, what's the plague mask modeled after? What bird? Huh? Because that's what it looks like. Is it a crow? I think it's a crow. Anyways, it reminds me of the crows, you know, in the Dumbo movie, you know, where he says, you know what he says? I seen a peanut stand. I heard a rubber band. I saw a needle that winked its eye. But I deep down seen bite everything when I seen an elephant fly. It's one of my favorite songs from the movie. I heard a front porch swing. I saw a diamond ring. Anyway, cool little crow here, all made of wood, adorable. I just love him. I think he's adorable. He's going to be $18. He's number 867. 867. I love him. I like to save the best there on the last one. Put you down there. It's pouring. It's raining pouring. Old men are snoring. Go lie down, please. Okay. Now we're going to do Everything's a Dollar. Everything's a dollar, a dollop, a daisy. Okay, can I shut this light off? Nope, I can't shut that light off, can I? Well, I might have just shut it off. Okay, there we go. I thought maybe I could get away with shutting it off. I'm going to have to move that here. Excuse me while I readjust. If you need to go use your restroom, you might want to do that now. When you come back from the restroom, I'm going to be ready to show you a whole bunch of things for a dollar. Oops. Get my light working. Put you up here. Let's see. Okay. Give me just a second. So, you know, sometimes we go kind of fast. You want the tea, Nancy? Nancy's going to try the tea. Yay. Probably make some sun tea with it. It can make, give you some energy out in the sun. And then you can go garden. I need a little bit more water. Okay. I'm going to be talking a lot run fast for this $1 thing we got coming up here. Put it down. Here, baby. There you go, buddy. Go get it. Oh, that's going to be a hard one to find. Did you get it? You got it. You got it. It's 12:48. I'm going to get through this. We're going to get some dollar things. Where am I going to put all these things once I open them up? Readjust, readjust. I will put them all right in this box. Okay. Okay, so I will give this a number. I wanted to use my 500 numbers for this. Okay. But I know I messed up and I used some 500 numbers a little bit earlier. I think I have. use the camera as a mirror. I think I have mulberries stuck in my teeth. Okay. So anything from this point forward is a dollar. If you like it, you just claim it. You claim it fast. Anybody have anything to tell me before I start? Anything you can tell me, anything you want to tell me. Have a secret?
Okay, I'm going to start. Maybe you'll come up with something to tell me.
And then I'll have to stop and take a break. And that's fine, because I'd like to take a break and read what you write.
Okay, so first item here. Let's see, which is going to be the first item here. First, let's do this one. This first item here is a book. It's called How to Heal a Broken Heart in 30 Days. How to Heal a Broken Heart in 30 Days. Paperback book, great condition. Item number 506. I make no guarantees if it works or not. 506. 507. You're getting this bag. This is an old school bag of gold marbles. Gold clear marbles. They look like that. Okay. Old school bag, gold clear marbles. It's number 507. 508. You are getting a bag of these pastel colored shells. These are seashells. They are actual seashells. They are pastel colors, and they have holes in them too, so you can string them up for something if you want to string them up for something or whatever you do. Make something out of it. You can make jewelry out of it, I guess, or you could, I don't know, make a wind chime out of it, whatever you like. Number 508, pastel bells. 509. What's this? 509. Okay, so this is a set of art prints. These are all 8x10. You get two of them that are on canvas here. They almost look like sound waves, don't they? Pretty little art prints here. This is canvas that they're on. They're 8x10. And then you get these four. These are on really high-grade photography paper here. I don't know what this is necessarily. It's just like marble images here. Or ocean images, maybe, something like that. These would also, when I was opening these, I was thinking, well, it seems like an odd thing to frame. You know, it seems like it's almost like a background to something. But the paper quality is extremely high quality. But these might be good for scrapbooking ideas. So if you're a scrapbooker, it's only a buck. You get all four, how many pieces? Six pieces in here. Six pieces, number 509. You might be able to find some value in that. Number 509, $1. Here's another piece of artwork here. This is a little bit larger. This is just a poster. You got a Mary and Baby Jesus poster. It's larger. It's this size here. Okay. And again, super high quality paper. It's a photography, Fujifilm photography paper. You can't read it, but it's the emblem's all through there that it's on. So we got this one here, and it is $1. Okay, that's number 510. 510. Then we got this one here. So these are 25 mini sheet protectors, okay? These are acid-free, heavyweight sheet protectors, size 5.5 by 8.5 inches. They can go in a mini binder here, okay? You're getting 25 in here. They sell for $6.05 a pack. They're going to be $1 a pack. Okay, so we got here, we got 511, we got 512, we got 513, and 514. Okay, so if you can use those, 25 in a pack, 511, 512, 513, and 514, acid-free, for your notebooks there. Then we have this one. This is a bottomless bath overflow drain cover. You put this, as it shows in the picture here, here's your spout in your bath, and you put that over here so that it doesn't go down the drain here. It's a plastic item here, silicone sort of item. It's item number 515, $1. Then we have this. It's a vintage little item here. It's a real sweet little vintage plate. And it says thank you. It's just a sweet little vintage item here. It has daisies on it. Thank you. It's trimmed in gold. You can see the back of it there. It's going to be item 516. It's $1. So I'd say it's about a 4-inch plate. Vintage item there. Okay, this is a bunch of, this is a crafty item here. These are iron-on letters. Okay, iron-on letters, like this. You have a bag of all of your iron-on letters here. if you like that. That's item number 517, iron on letters. Okay. Then we have this. This is a good stocking stuffer here. This is a wooden choo-choo train whistle. Okay, so it replicates the sound of a choo-choo train. Train whistle, wooden. It's going to be item number 518. Okay. Then we have this one here is 519. This is your baby teething ring, number 519. It is shaped like an elephant. Where is the elephant? There he is. Baby teething ring, silicone, 519. You can also attach a something safe around here so that it stays close to your baby. Okay. Next we have here, this is kind of like a pink salmon color of ostrich feathers here, okay? So this is a new item. Oh, they're so soft and pretty and silky. I want to rub these all over me too. Pink ostrich feathers there. Look, I could be the female Thor, fly away. Is that Thor or Captain America? Might be, I don't know. Either one of either. You get the pretty little ostrich feathers here. I don't know if it says how many are in here. There's probably a dozen or two dozen in here. It's a new item. Oh, come on in there. They're so delicate. But just $1 for them. It's going to be item number 520. And then we have here, this is the six-sided nail file here. Six-sided nail file is going to be item number 521. Manicure file. And then we have a pair of the white, kind of like those 1980s Max Headroom. These are the glasses here, white plastic glasses. But you pull out the little thing in here and you can push the button. And then they glow and they flash and they look all cool. There's like a little paper that you have to pull out so that the batteries become activated there. Flashy glasses in white are going to be item 522. This is a vintage item here. It's going to be item number 523. Okay, so this is a political pocket trivia political game here. So they're cards. They're from 1984. Okay, 1984, so base your political questions around then. And it just says Series 6 political trivia game, okay? Two or more players. So it's just like a little quiz game. But it's kind of cool because I'm sure that a few of us on here, that was kind of our years probably starting out coming into politics, becoming aware of things that were going on in the world around that time, maybe. It's going to be item number 523, so test your knowledge. See if you got old. How about that? Just see if you got old. You might have gotten old. Who knows? Okay, next item here is 524. This is a set of travel stickers. You could use these. These would be pretty if you were making a, they're from Pier 1. Okay, so they're just different countries travel stickers here. They're nice size. They're nice and big. Okay. There you go. Item number 524. That'd be cute on an old suitcase or something like that. A little travel thing here. Oh, this has stopped raining. I'm so stuck with sticker pieces on me right now. They're everywhere, sticking to me. Okay, this one here is a baking pan. It's item number 525. It is a consigned item. It's pretty darn clean, though. It's 525 baking pan. Round baking pan, 525. 526, I don't know if this is how you'd use these, if these are universal or not. It says it is, what does it say? It says lids are not safe for microwave. Okay, so I don't know if these go to something particular or not. It's item number 526. It looks like three lids. They have a rubberized thing here, and then they bend down. But I don't have anything else that goes with these here, so I don't know if you own this style of plasticware at your house. 526 is going to be $1. Then we have here 527. Oh, 527 is this embroidery floss. It's white, and you get four skeins of it here. White embroidery floss. And that is number 527. Four skeins of embroidery floss. And they put it in this great big pouch for those four skeins of embroidery floss. 528. I love these books. These are the little flip books here. This one's shark. Shark! Kids love these little books too. There's shark going backward. Cool little thing here. $5.28, $1 for that. $5.29, $5.30, $5.31. All the same item here. Let me stick some sticks on here. Okay, so these are also stickers here. These are meme stickers, okay? So these are some popular memes over the years here. And you put them on whatever you want to be funny and jokes or, you know, they're actually, I think they're billed as teacher memes stickers for teachers' works here. So you see some of your more popular memes over the years. And they have different sayings on, such as, you know, wow, that'd be great. Good job. You woke up perfect. Wait, say what? You know, so they're kind of like related to things that maybe a teacher could put on their paper here that would still be appropriate. Okay, maybe next time. I believe you can fly. You know, that all that sort of thing. So we have, they're big. They're big sheets. 529, 530, and 531. Okay. Next item here. This is just a standard white ruled notebook, but it has a nice wipeable surface cover on the front here. The cover says, "The happiest people don't have the best of everything. They just make the best of everything." Three hole punch, white lined ruled paper here. Notebook, gonna be item number 532. This is the vintage Garfield coloring book. What did we figure out it was from? 2002, almost vintage. 2002, Garfield coloring book. Old school Garfield coloring book is going to be item number 533. $1. Everything you see is $1. Okay, so next here, we're going to do both of these ones together. You think I should do these together? I think I should. I'm just doing them together. Okay, so item 534. These are for children. These are little vinyl bracelets, okay? And they're both identical, the packages here. But these are for when you're taking children somewhere and you don't want them to get lost. So you have to write your information or stick your address label or phone number or something on here for a young child. Psst. Hey, what are you doing? Item number 534, and I don't know, it looks like you get maybe six in each package, maybe five in each package or so. Off, please. You're going to get both packages, item number 534. Item number 535, this is a set of Hot Wheels license plate. This is for your bicycle, though, okay? It does not say Hot Wheels on there. This is on the plastic on the outside. So this is for your bicycle. You can create your own plate. It looks like there is some, maybe some letters behind here for you to put on your own plate. It looks like it from here, okay? This one's going to be item number 535. This item here is 536. This is, these are not really socks, but these are like for, they kind of look like wristbands is what they look like, but what they really are for is their heel bands, okay? So if you were doing yoga, floor exercises or something like that, and you're in your bare feet, and you just need a little bit of, slide or grip, or I don't know, one or the other, I don't know what you need, but you wrap it on your heel. These are for your heels, so you're not actually wearing socks, you're barefoot, and then you just have this little piece on your heel so that maybe you could move a little bit easier or so. You get two packs in here. They're item 536. Okay, this one right here fell out of a bag. I don't know what the bag is supposed to have in it. This is a compression sleeve. This is a new item. I don't know where the bag is for it, though. It's item number 537. It is beige. It looks medical-ish looking. It's a compression sleeve, but you can see that it... I don't want to ruin the bracelets. So you have open... Four fingers go through here. One thumb goes through here. And it's kind of tight like this, okay? And then it goes straight up your arm, and I guess you strap it on up at the top. It has like buttons here up at the top, adjustable buttons and whatnot. So, I don't know why it wouldn't stay up on its own. It has a lot of elastic in it. I'm not real sure. But anyways, that's how it is. It's item number 537. Item 537. This right here is going to be item number 538. Oh, can't see. This says this is a slim privacy screen for a 7.9-inch iPad mini. If you have a 7.9-inch iPad mini, here is your privacy screens here. Okay, so if you want that, it's going to be $1. It's item number 538. 538 is $1. Here's item number 539. It's a set of two old school Tupperware cups, okay? These are the old school Tupperware cups. This one has a little mark on it here, like a almost like a burn mark here. It doesn't go through, but it is there on the outside. These are not like the ones I showed you the other day, which were a little bit more modern. These are the old school ones, sippy cups here like this. Two of them here is going to be item number 539. Item number 540. Item number 540. We're going to do both of these for 540. You get these two little beanie dogs here. This one looks like Clifford, the big red dog. And this one looks like, does he look like a Doberman or a Rottie or something like that? You're getting two of these little bean dogs here for item number 540. 540. Okay. Item number 541. We got this Look and Finds. I feel like I need peppier music right now. What are you saying? Traction. 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 A Robin. Hi, Robin. When did you join in? Good to see you here. Traction. Traction for the yoga. Yes. Okay, there you go. There you go. Okay, next item here. Look and Find Superman. This is a hardbound book. Superman Look and Find book. Okay, so it gives you a clue, a little key here, and then you search the images and you try to find what you want. It's item number 541. 541. And then we have item number 542. This is a photo journal. Again, hardbound book, pretty book here. And you open it up and you slip in, these are cardboard pages, and you slip in your photographs here that you want to slip in. They're all the exact same size openings on them here, and this it says photo journal. Does have a tiny little pinhole right there, if you see that in the front. This one is going to be item number 542. 542, $1. Item number 543. 543, we're getting three packages of Betty Crocker's blue birthday candles. Okay. Three packages, Betty Crocker, blue birthday candles, and each package has, I don't know how many, 24 in each package. So, you know, you can just celebrate somebody up to 72 years old here, okay? Item number 543. Item number 544 is this, this is like a graphic novel here. It is Marvel's Thor Avengers. Okay, it's a smaller size graphic novel, item number 544. Okay, there we go. Item number 545, this is a nice little book here. This is a how to draw book. And this one is this isn't going to be a two-parter. Okay, so you're going to get this one that says how to draw grotesque monsters. Okay, so it's teaching you how to draw if you have somebody in your life that likes to draw. And then it's also, we're also going to put this one with it too. And this is a set of scars, 18 tattoos, scars. So they're both going to be together here, and that's going to be $1. And that's going to be item number 545. Next item here is going to be item 546. This is, it's a product called Boyfriend Replacement, the Chocolate Recovery Bath, Boyfriend Replacement. And it says, I think what it is this when you break up with your boyfriend here, then it comes with these little things to indulge you that are in the scent of chocolate things here, okay? 546 Boyfriend Replacement, the Chocolate Recovery Bath. So it has like bath stuff in it, in the scent of chocolate. 546. $1 for that. Then we have this, which is 547. This is, it's just a USB cable. USB cable, it's a kind of copper color, and it's super tiny one here. It's a real tiny little one. So if you need to carry some information from one place to another, it's item 547, it's $1. 548, this is a nice model. It is a, it's a shark, but it's a nice shark. It's not a dollar store shark. It's a nice shark, okay? So I'm going to think that this is probably like originally like $6 or $7 for this shark here. But he's a dollar right now. He's going to be item number 548. 549 is going to be this sweet little hand tally counter. When you have a whole bunch of things that you have to count. Oh, look. Oh, wait. No, that's, I was wrong. So you have a whole bunch of things you have to count, and you just do that. Okay, yeah, I know. Okay, how many are you going through? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know, blah, 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 blah. And so you attach it to your belt or your waist or whatever you want here. A little hand tally counter in the color black. This one is going to be item number 549. Okay. Number 550 here is going to be, these are just little, you can wear these as a necklace if you want. They are little vials, and inside of the little vials comes bubble solution and a bubble wand, okay? And I'm going to say that each of these are probably maybe, they're like 3 or 4 inches long, let's say. So you can wear it as a necklace if you want, you know, pass out as little party favors or something like that, or whatever you want. I don't know how many are here. There's maybe 10 or 12 in this package here. It's item number 550. It's going to be $1 here. Let's see. Oh, I need more stickers. Give me a second here. Hold on. And let me take a drink. Okay, go to the bathroom if you have to go to the bathroom. Because we have a little bit more to do, just a little bit more. Did I lose you? As long as I didn't lose you. Maybe I'm losing you too much. I see we might be losing a couple people. Give me a second here. Give me just a second. Okay, where is that box at? Okay, here we go. Here, this one here for me. Can you touch my office? Okay, I gotta get my stickers. Here we go. Here we go. Right here, please. Thank you. I don't know. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Are you still with me? Okay. So, 551. Oops. I keep taking the wrong thing out here. 551. We got this, which these are little... So these are like... You know what... These are little pieces of felt, soft felt. It's almost like, I kind of want to say the word moleskin, okay? You're getting a lot of these in here, these squares in here. I don't know what you would use them for. Maybe some sort of craft project or something like that. There's probably 30 squares, 40 squares inside of here, and they're large too, like 4 inches by 4 inches. So I'm not sure what you would use them for, but, and they have, you peel off the back and it becomes a sticker, okay? So they're pre-stuck here. Item number 551, 551, $1. I'm not going to go over and continue to explain something that's a dollar. It's a dollar. Take a chance. 552 is a natural loofah. This is a natural loofah, bath loofah on a string here. 552, natural loofah. 553. This is an avocado tool. I know I had one of these before, but it came with other things. This is just the tool alone here. Look, it has a little knife here, and it has, this might be the pitter here for your inner, and this is how to slice your avocado. It's item number 553, $1. Item number 554, you got Ernest Hemingway book, In Our Time, Ernest Hemingway book. Item number 554, $1, In Our Time. Item number 555, $1, Marvel comic books. Look and find Amazing Spider-Man. Amazing Spider-Man, we open this guy up. And we, again, same type of thing. You have a key over here, and then you're doing like a Where's Waldo type of thing over here. Hardbound book. This one is item number 555. If you like that, you just write sold, space, 555. The next one here, you are getting 3 boxes of these. Each box has 6 of these in, I think. I can't see what that says.
3 foil, 3 black and white twine, and you get twine for hanging. Okay, so these are little fans. These are decorative. They're like for a party. So you, it comes with the cording that you get here. And then you get these little kind of like bunting type thing, you know, these little fans here. You're getting 3 packages of these. Banner kit. You can line them all up like a banner if you want to here. All 3 packages. Super good deal. For $1, it's item number 556. All 3 packages. 556. Then we have this sweet little Minnie Mouse, or Mickey Mouse, I guess. First birthday party hat. First birthday party hat with the pom-pom and the Mickey Mouse, and it has the number 1 little elastic thing here like that. Isn't that sweet? That one's 557. That one's just $1 as well. Okay, I need something peppier than this music right now. He's putting me to sleep right now. I know you like it, but he's putting me to sleep. Okay, so these right here, these are those things I told you I can't believe they sell for this much. These things sell for, what did I say they sell for? $9.99. So what comes in the package are these. And these are little plastic. You put them together like Easter eggs type thing, but like little ornaments, little plastic ornaments. And then they have holes at the top that you can make them into necklaces. So if you want to make like little baby snow globe necklaces, that's what they are. You put them all together like that. I can't believe these sell for $9.99. You're getting them for $1. It's item number 558. And there's a whole bunch in there. I think it makes like 24 or something like that. 558. 558. It'd be a cute little Christmas project to make. Put some little glitter inside of them. You know, maybe hot glue gun, a little tiny little figurine or something like that. And make little snow globe necklaces. This is a tiny little shirt here. I'm going to venture to say this is for maybe a little girl or something like that that might be tiny. I don't know how old she'd have to be. I'm guessing. I don't see a size. Oh, does it have a size? I'm sorry. I guess I could have looked at the size. The size says... it's a new item, but it doesn't have its size here. It says sportswear, okay? And it says love at the bottom, and it's stretchy and it's meshy here. I mean, maybe it's for a skinny young adult. I don't know. Anyways, I have no clue what it is. If I had to guess looking at it, I'm going to say like maybe like an 8-year-old kid is what I'm going to say, okay? That's what might be my first guess, but hey, it could be a teenager for all I know. It's item number 559. You can figure it out. Item number 560. Okay, so this is the plastic thing. You can see that it's kind of, you rip it apart here. There's a texture side. You lay it in your vehicle like this. So it's a no slid surface, no sliding surface for if you want to toss your keys or your cell phones or something like that. It's traction. It's traction, not just traction for your feet, traction for your car. It's item 560 there. What do we got here? Oh, here we have a beard styling tool, okay? So this one here is for you to, you know, measure how you're going to plan out your beard here. Beard styling tool. See if you can go in various techniques here. Beard styling tool. It's going to be item 561. This would be a good stocking stuffer, actually, okay? 561 beard styling tool, $1. This one here is a CD. It's an audiobook here called Stuart Wood's Kisser, and you get how many different CDs in here? You get like 5 different CDs inside of here, and this one is going to be $1. It's 562 audiobook, 562. Okay, the Kisser, 562. 563, we got a little bell here, little charming little school bell here. Hello, can I have your attention? Hello, are you still with me? Please, mommy, may I have some more porridge? Oh, you people, come on, talk to me. Tell me something funny out there. Oh, I got something funny for you right here. Here's 564. Brand new. We got a whip. We got a black, well, I don't think it's actually leather, but a black simulated leather whip here. Do what you want with it. You can write, you can send postcards. 564 leather whip. What is this?
This is $5.65. This is a pair of reading glasses, and they are in the one and a half. Oh, they look like they need to be cleaned. There they are. They're round reading glasses. $1.50. Okay. And those here, maybe those are just my dirty fingerprints. I can't see. Those are going to be item number 565, 150 readers. 566. This is a cute little key ring. Good stocking stuffer here, too. There we go. There's, is that Boba Fett? Is that who that is? I think so. I think so. 566, metal key ring. Good stocking stuffer there. 567. 567, really pretty, nice weight to it, metal, fancy shoe. It's a fancy little shoe. It has enamel on it. It's like a piece of jewelry almost here. You can put a little name tag or a little picture or something like that on it. It has rhinestones on it. It has a nice weight to it here. It's $5.67, $1. $5.68. We had baby bubbles before. Now we have big bubbles. Big bubbles, $5.68. Big bubbles. Bubbles, $1, $5.68. Instead of three bubbles. What is this one? $5.69. Oh, we have baby binkies. Baby binkies, $5.69. These are so, this is the part that's getting on my nerves, all this little scrappy stuff that's everywhere. $5.69. Baby binkies, set of two baby binkies. $5.69. $1. $5.70. Okay, so this is the flag pendants. Okay, they are made of a they're kind of like a cloth. You could use it as a party decoration you want to, or if you're doing like some kind of race car party or race car themed bedroom or anything like that. They are the pendants that go like a car dealership would have. Going across the top here. It's item number 570. It's the black and white checkered flag. It's going to be $1. $1 for that. What is this one here? Okay, we can leave that here. Let's go here. 571. It's going to be this. This is just a mouse pad. If you need a new mouse pad, this has kind of has like a little Sahara chevron-y sort of look to it here. 571 mouse pad here. 572. This is a sweet little, it's a little beanie baby. 572. It's a little teddy bear beanie baby. There you go. Cute, tiny, teeny little thing. Very sweet. 572. 573. This is, it says jewelry essentials, bead clips. I don't know what these are. I don't make jewelry, so I can't help you out with that. It says item 573, and they look like they come in gold, silver, brass here. Jewelry findings, bead clips, 573. Okay. 574. 574. 574 is these cute little magnets, and they are cute little magnets here. You're getting, they look like little sea, oh, it's hard for me to show you here. Look how cute they are. They're like little starfish here. They're nice thick ones, too. I don't know what they all say on them, but they're a dollar. They're cute little refrigerator magnets here. So they're sand dollars. All kinds of little things like that. Bag of these little magnets is item number 574. 574. This one here, 575, this is a little needlework kit, okay? 575, it says it is a friendship candle cross stitch kit. This is all the stuff that comes inside of it. You get your little, oh, everything you need, little kit here. This is going to be 575. It's busy work to keep you busy when you're waiting for on traffic or something. Okay, 576. Can't have summer without having a luau at some point. These are Lay's, plastic Lay's here. You're getting orange, blue, green, and white plastic Lay's. All sealed up tight here. They're new. I'm assuming there's one in each package, but to be honest, I didn't open them up to see how many are in each package. It's five number five. Excuse me, side number 576. Plastic vase, 576. 577 are these stickers here. These are, oh, now I ripped the package. These are heart stickers here, but they're kind of all a little bit different. Okay. There you go. They're all a little bit different. They're shiny and foiled too. And they're item number 577. Let me see what's going on here. You good? Okay. 577. Hey, sun came back out. Sun came back out. Right, which is nice. Okay, let's see what this is here. Ooh. Oh, I love these. I love these. I super love these. My kid is like, yeah, he didn't care about them, but I love these. These are number 578. These are pencils that are drumsticks. They're wood pencils, okay? But they're drumsticks. I could just see totally beating on these all day here. Pencils, 578. $1. $1. Okay, here we go. Here is item number. Oops, this goes with it. I think this goes with it. Yes. This is an eyebrow stencil kit here. So this is item number 579. So you have this, there's, you get the stencils here for the different styles of eyebrows here. And then you get your measuring, like how to measure your particular brows here that go with it here. And so some people do this and they use henna, you know, so it's kind of a permanent thing. It's like a permanent tattoo. And that's number 579. 579. And then this one right here, which is 580. This is also another new item. So cute. Little piratey hat.
Oi! Oi, matey!
This is just for the first time at this many years old that I actually am, that I saw, did I see it on Facebook? Maybe somebody wrote it on something. Somebody, I think, wrote it on my Facebook. And it said something about, trust, something about the, I know why. Okay, it was something about the Gorton's Fisherman. Trust the Gorton's Fisherman. But they spelled it, I always thought it was Gorton, and it's Gordon, or vice versa. I can't remember what it is right now. Anyway, cool hat, cool embroidery, gold embroidery around the side there. We got this one is number 580. Trust the Gorton Fisherman, right? Right? Now I'm going to be singing it like an earworm all day long. Okay, this is a little CD here. Oh, no, this is a CD-ROM. Excuse me. This is coloring pages for your preschooler. It has, you put it in your computer and you print out the pages on your printer here. This says Play and Worship, coloring pages for preschoolers. So it's 50 coloring pages, designs that you can print out. Say you taught a little class or something like that. 581. 581. We'll put these two together here. It's talking about the, what was I talking about? The Boba Fett there. We're going to put these two together here to make them 582. You're going to get these two Star Wars signs here. They're like a heavy-duty cardboard sign here. And this one says, join the dark side. And this one says, bleep, bleep, blop. And that's what they say on the reverse side of them, too. They already have a little hole in the top that you can thumbtack it up to where you want or however you want to do it. You get two of these heavy-duty signs here. There's going to be $1. Did I tell you what the number was on them? The number for this one is 582. 582, people. What is this? Oh, these are for your hair. These are, this is 583. These are what you call like a hair bump, okay? So they're small barrettes. Okay, and they're kind of fuzzy, not fuzzy, but like the loopy side of the Velcro, I'd say. And you put them in your hair, and then you push your hair over it. So it gives you a little bit of a bump to your hairstyle there. It tells you how to do it there in the back. This one here is item number 583. Oh, here we go. Here's Abraham Lincoln's Gettysburg Address of 1963. Yes, it's the original. And... But here it is. the Gettysburg Address. So it's written on this old school parchment paper here. This would be a great little at-school learning, home learning aid, Lincoln's Gettysburg Address. Item 584 is going to be $1. Never know what I'm going to have. You never, ever know. $1, 584. This one here is, let's see what we can put that one with. Let's put that one with this one here. Okay, so this one here is a set of letters, and they're large letters. They're peel-off sticky letters. I'm guessing they're sticky letters. I don't think they're vinyl. No, they have stick on the back of them. Oh, they're kind of heavy duty too. But a couple of these have apparently been used already, okay? So I want to let you know that. But again, you're getting a bunch of pages of them here. Let's see, just turn them down here. So you got somebody wrote something. Maybe it will be a mystery just to buy it and figure out what the heck it was that they wrote. But you get a whole bunch of these pages here of these large glittery stickers. They're about 3 or 4 inches tall, and we're going to put in this telephone and address book with it as well, because some of those were used, and why not? Okay, so those two items are going to be item number 585 for the set of those two, and that's going to be $1. Oh, you still with me, people? You still with me? Couple more here. Let's see. Okay, so this here, these are velvet bags. I don't know what you'd use these for. The first thing that comes to my mind is if you were setting a holiday table and you were using chopsticks. These are red velvet bags, okay? And you can pull them tight like that up at the top. They're new. You're getting what? It looks like you're getting 12, 10, something like that, of these red velvet bags. So if you can think, you put candy canes in them. Put a fancy candy cane sticking out the top of it for Christmas time there. But you're getting the whole stack of them here, and then they have the little red ties at the top. It's going to be item 586. You could do that. You could do, I don't know, what else could you think of that you could put inside of there? I was thinking they'd be pretty on a table setting to put chopsticks in and have them there, and you know, I don't know. I was thinking that would be pretty, but you could use candy canes, makeup brushes. I don't know what you could use them for. 586. You could give everybody toothbrushes for Christmas and put them in here on their package. 586 is the number for those. These are nice, people. I don't have a lot of you people buying these, and you should be buying these. These are men's socks. These are men's dress socks. So when your man has to go to something that he needs to wear dress socks, these are brown colored men's dress socks. They are nice quality socks here. It's item number 587, just $1. 587, just $1. What is this? This is a house number. Oh, it's just one number. I don't know how that's going to serve you too well. Unless you live at number 8. Do you live at number 8? It's stainless steel, number 8. Brushed nickel, I suppose, is what they call it there. But maybe you could just hang it like that and be like, hey, I live at infinity. So if you need a large, heavy-duty stainless steel house number 8, I don't know if you do or not, but I got one of them, just one of them. It's item number 588. It'd be cooler to do something in the infinity mode for it, I think, there. What is in here? This is item number 589. Where did my glasses go? They was on my head, and then they weren't. Next thing I know, they weren't. There they are. There they are. Oh, my glasses. Okay, these are, okay, so these sell for $11.99, okay? But again, I don't really have a lot of people that are going to be buying this. So maybe you have an event coming up. Maybe you have a wedding coming up. I think you get 100 in here. These are the glitter acrylic drink mixers here, okay? I don't know if you get 100. You get a lot. You get a whole bunch. Maybe you can think of a craft project to make with them. Getting them for $1 right now. Number 589, $1. Big box full of them. You should look on Pinterest, see if there's not an idea of what to do with those for $1, really. $1. Then what's here? Oh. Okay, let's see who you are. No, we're going to keep you over here. I don't know where to go with these. Okay, let's do these guys here. Okay, first of all, here's another ball cap. This is a number 590. This is a ball cap that says, proud to be American, and it says Cities of Gold Casino, Buffalo Thunder Resort and Casino. Okay, so that's what that would look like here. Okay, that's going to be $1. And then this one here, sometimes people collect ball caps, you know. This one here says item number 591. This one here says United States, U.S. 2000. U.S. 2000, United States. That's all it says. Okay. It's officially a vintage cap. United States year 2000. $1, peoples. $1, $1, $1, $1. Then we have here, we have a set of two of these cookie cutters. These are the nice cookie cutters. Of course, I lost the book now. Here's the book. These are from the brand called Ann Clark. Ann Clark Cookie Company book here. This is a little cross and a little dress. So I think these would be good for a, if you were doing like a christening party or, you know, a baptism or something like that. So that's, you got both of them for $1, and Clark Cookie Company. But you know, you can make other things with it too. You can make, heck, you can make birdseed ornaments. Use the cookie shape to do that. You can make birdseed in soot and that sort of thing. Or you could make clay, all kinds of things. That one's gonna be item number 592. If you like that one, you tell me number 592. And what else do I got over here? Let's see. I wanted to put that with something. Okay. We did those here. Okay, so let's do these. We're going to do both of these together. I think we did these together before. And I didn't have anybody pick this up, but somebody should have picked these up. You should pick these up. They're $1 for both packs. My gosh. It's item number 593. And there you get the two sets. And look how cute these two sets are of taco holders. That's what they look like. You make these little things. So you have a little taco night at your house here. And you put them all inside these little cardboard things. And then people can go around and it looks nice on the table. You know, you have a party. Taco holders here. Two sets. Each package has 12 pieces in it. That's 24 tacos, people. 24 tacos for $1. $5.93. Well, not the whole taco. You don't get the whole taco. And really, I don't think I'd want to buy 24 tacos for $1. That's questionable, huh? Okay. Let me see if I have anything else here I want to share with you today. Oh, I got a lot of okay, here we go. I say I have a lot of disorganized things here. And what do I have going on right here? The Procrastinator's Handbook, Mastering the Art of Doing It Now. Do it now, Val. Do it now. $5.94. That was self-talk. That wasn't to you, Valerie. Item 594, The Procrastinator's Handbook. There we go. I'm going to settle on one more thing, and then we're going to say goodbye to one another here. And the very last thing that I will do today for $1. Come on, let's get me something in here that I think is something. What's this? Can I do this? Is that a good piece here? I think this is a good piece here. Okay, here. So let's take this one here, and we'll do this as the very last one. This is a porcelain mug here. I don't see anything wrong with it here. It says Irish Coffee. Irish coffee mug, and it has a tiny little shamrock in there. Irish coffee is going to be $1. That's going to be our last item today. It's going to be item number 595. Irish coffee. 595. Woo-hoo! Woo! We did good. What time is it? I can't even see far away because I have too many lights on. 1:38, I think is what it says. 1:38, is that what it says? Oh my gosh, you people are wonderful, and thank you so much for staying with me for so long. The ones that did, I know some of you fell asleep. That's okay. That's perfectly okay. Hey, listen, I'm going to be back here on Wednesday evening, not at 11 a.m. I'm going to come back at Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. I know, you want to say goodbye too. Wednesday evening is 7 p.m. So until that time, I will get together your things I have to get together. And I thank you so much for joining me today. And where I am, the sun's shining, so I hope it's shining where you are too. Have a great day. Bye, everybody.